crime and security in general has become issues in the country. And we are privileged to have Chief Inspector retired Michael Asamoah. He has been in the service for about 4 decades. He is a social communicator, a security analyst, and a UN veteran. We are going to him to have an in-depth analysis and explanation to the security crisis that we have in the country now. You will be the judge. I am Joshua Opu ICP. Stay tuned.
You're welcome today. Thank you for having me. All right, sir. So as we were saying, sir, could you tell us a brief history of your stay in the police service?
Thank you for the opportunity. I was enlisted into the police service in 1972, passed out in 1973. Stayed in the pay office for a while until became self-accountant, then moved to the general duties area, became a detective for almost about 30 years. We had a very good experience in the service at that time. That was in the 70s. Yes.
Okay. So upon your own experience, comparing the current police service to the past, what can you say about it? Are we progressing or retrogressing?
Well, to the best of my knowledge and ability, there is a gradual progression. But it appears over politicization of the police service has created a lot of problems for them. And the police administrators don't bite the way they should have. I don't say they should be so wicked or something, but they've been given a mandate, and because of political interference, they do not normally perform like the way society would have expected them to.
Okay, you said. And there have been rising cases of crime in Ghana lately. What do you think are the causes of this crime in this current Ghanaian society?
High crime wave is a global phenomenon. And I wouldn't attribute to the laxity or incompetence of the police per se, but I personally, sociologically, there is much crime, there's a decadence in our society, lawlessness in our society. And the way crime climbs up, it is up to the police officers also to push up to meet these challenges. So that's much. People always trying to have their civil rights or legal rights and things, and you see, it had made the police service an affront to them. They feel the police is really shielding them from having their human rights. So it's a societal problem. It's global. Crime wave is high.
Okay, sir. The police service has come over a lot of attack from the public, of which a lot of members in the police are killed. Estimated that in 2019 they got 9 police officers killed. What do you think are the causes of this attack on the police service? Some have attributed that the cause are mistrust and indiscipline among the police service that is attracting this public brutality on the police. Do you reason with this cause, sir?
I would say yes or no, or yes and no. As I earlier said, there is much societal indiscipline, and that has made the police work very difficult. Now, yes, in the sense that most police officers of today are not professional. The way they go about their duties, the way they carry themselves. And it creates a lot of suspicion and enmity with the public. So I would say yes, unprofessionalism or unprofessional practice by police officers of today has also been the bane. It comes up to training when they go to the training schools. You see, they should be given the basic training so that when they come out, they can meet challenges. But let me tell you one thing. The best of professional police officer is the one who, whilst on the ground, meets challenges and proves his professionalism. In the training people, you might be top one or two things, but when you come to the field, it is where the challenges come. And when the challenges meet you, the way you approach their challenges, the way you manage them, and the way you control them will make you an effective police officer. So yes, most of these policemen of today are very unprofessional, and it appears that subversive powers in the system is far winning. And now it comes back to things that I've been saying always, that politicization of the police service. When this political power comes, they will bring in their people and walk to be enlisted, when another party comes, and that sort of thing. You see, they pass through the back door, and they don't move through the mainstream screening. So we get very lackluster police officers who come out and they misperform or underperform. Yes.
Okay, Chief, on that note, what are you going to say will be the solutions for this backdoor recruitment and stuff like that?
I think during enlistment into the police service, there should be a proper committee or a commission that will see to a non-partisan committee that will also supervise this the enlistment process. We have the police council, and I think with the IGP, they can form a subcommittee that will supervise the enlistment, so that you get people who are committed to serve the nation as police officers, and not people who just want work and politicians push them, their sons and daughters and their siblings, they just push them into the system. Now, when after training they come out, they see that there is much difficulty of challenging the service, and they can't perform. So there should be a special committee to assist in the enlistment of genuine and dedicated Ghanaians who want to serve the state as police officers.
Thank you, sir. Due to the attacks on the police service, the Minister of Interior, Mr. Andrew Derry, have directed that he's going to arm police officers with guns. Others say this directive is going to destroy the police service rather than save it. What is your assessment of that issue?
Well, I think the statement by the Interior Minister was too quick. He should have taken time. Let's see America and Europe. Policemen are armed. And look at the killings that go on in America, for instance. Shooting of blacks and that sort of thing. So, you see, making police armed to the teeth wouldn't solve the problem. I think there should be proper training. You see, it's a different thing being armed and a different thing knowing how to handle the weapon. The MTTD, for instance, whom this new order is intended for, say, they should arm the MTTD. Look at the relationship between the drivers and the police. There is much anger and that sort of thing. So if a police officer who is armed does not hold his anger, can become trigger happy, can start to kill. So I mean, I don't think it's a good idea. I mean, them to the teeth will create a lot of problems. But rather, if they can get armed backup for these people when they're on their highway patrols or on their doing their duty tour, it will be fine. But arming them to the teeth will be a very dangerous thing, because they might be trigger happy and we might see a lot of deaths in our streets. So they should come again and revisit the issue.
Okay. Chief, if you have the opportunity to become an IGP for a day, what will you change?
Personally, there is much indiscipline in the system because of the overpolitization of the prisons. So my main agenda, if I have the chance to be an IGP, is to raise the index of discipline in the service. Discipline, it does a lot of things. Yes.
Discipline, Chief said. Chief, do you have any final words for us?
I will appeal to the politicians of today, our legislature, and the person to give the IGP and the police administration the free hand to do their work. They have been given a core mandate, or constitutional core mandate, prevention of crime, maintenance of peace, arresting of offenders and prosecution of offenders. You see, they should give them time to do that. But where an IGP is there appointed by the government and is being manipulated, you become very ineffective. And this has happened in our country for so long that most of our security institutions have become toothless bulldogs. So the politicians and public officials should give the police administration the free hand to work. And we are one of the best in the world. No doubt about that. And the civilians also should be civil enough to be law abiding, so that we might have a very peaceful environment in our society.
Okay. That was Chief Inspector retired Michael Asamoah. We have learned a lot, and I hope you, the viewers, have also learned a lot. There was one word that I'm taking home: discipline. Discipline, he said, is the key of everything. Mr. Chief Inspector Michael Asamoah, retired, thank you for having us
Thank you too for having me.
Hello once again. What great lesson from the interview you had with Chief Inspector Michael Asamoah. Keep watching for more. My name is Nasechi. Thank you.